Hello and welcome to Just One More Watch. Welcome to something a bit different today. I haven't made this type of video before. It's essentially a giant preview. Six of what I think are the best micro brand watches that I've got coming in for review between now and the end of March, so first quarter 2021. So if you're a one in, one out type of collector, or maybe you're gonna have to squirrel away a few pennies if you wanna pick yourself up one of these, you can consider yourself warned. I'm gonna include all the prices and the release dates as I go along. Now, I talked about it in my top five, bottom five video that I made at the end of last year. One of my negatives in that video was market saturation. Now, I do not think the market is saturated. I hope it never gets to that stage, because if it does, then I'm out of a job. But particularly in terms of micro brands, I think the market is a lot more engorged than it was 12 months ago, say. And I think as a consequence, it's a good thing. It's gonna make companies have to work harder for my attention, for your attention, and for potentially some of your hard-earned cash over the next 12 months or so and beyond that. The simple stuff, the NH35 powered Submariner clones, just aren't gonna wash at the $300 price point on Kickstarter in the way that they probably did a couple of years ago. I think you're gonna see much more of a focus on color, on style, on innovation, and on all of the above at once. And that can only be good for me and good for you. And hopefully, in a sign of things to come for the market and for this channel, only three of these watches are dive watches, only two of them are powered by the Seiko NH, and two of them are Australian. So six watches that I'm going to be giving the full review treatment to between the end of January and the end of March. Indeed, I'm wearing one on my wrist today. Bit of an exclusive, I believe. I'm the first person to show this watch anywhere. And if you don't mind, because I've got six watches today, for the first time ever, I'm going to use notes. I've got a bit of a cheat sheet. Let's start, appropriately enough, with the first one. And first up is the RLG Odyssey 2021, aka the Odyssey Mark IV. Now, this is the artist formerly known as Richard Legrand Watches. They now have decided to officially rebrand as RLG Watches and have a new logo as a consequence. Now, I looked at the Odyssey Mark II and the Odyssey Mark III, but not the Odyssey Mark I. When I looked at the Odyssey Mark II in 2018, it blew my tiny mind. That was one of the best looking micro brand dive watches that I had looked at to that point. Sapphire bezel insert. How many of those have you seen on the channel, especially for $300 US? Great value. They sold a bunch of them as a consequence. They then updated to the Mark III, and they took the design in one particular direction. They made it slimmer, narrower, and upgraded the Seiko to a Miyota. They also added a multifaceted bracelet for extra comfort, and they have continued to add refinements with this new Mark IV. They've kept the Miyota. They made it slightly smaller again at 39mm with a lug-to-lug of 46. They've carried over the C3 loom, the domed dial for extra depth, and they now have a domed sapphire bezel insert mimicking the Baker-like designs of old. I mean, where do you get that other than Microland? Nowhere, that's your answer. They've continued to redesign the bracelet, including a new two-tone finish. Included in the package are a stainless steel bracelet as shown and Tropic rubber straps. Now, the regular price of these ones is gonna be $399. However, they're taking pre-orders in the mid 300s. That's all they would tell me from next month. I'll leave a link to this one in the description of the video. You can sign up for the very best price that they have on offer. Now, I talked about colors earlier on. They'll have the usual blue, green, and black, but also pastel blue. I think pastel blue is a color that is now synonymous with RLG as a brand. I'm very much looking forward to this one, and I'll be getting the pastel blue in hopefully next month for full review. Next up, it's a Phoebus. Now, I have reviewed a whole bunch of Phoebi on the channel over the last 4 years. I started my channel just after they started their company, and they know how to make a good watch. That is something that they have certainly grasped over the last few years. Stylistically, some of them have been a bit hit or miss for me anyway, including the Great Wall and the Sentinel. Wasn't too sure about those. My two favorites though have both been from the Eagle Ray range. The Eagle Ray Bronze I thought was an absolutely outstanding watch for the money, and the Eagle Ray GMT was probably their best looking watch to date. Quartz GMT sold out within minutes about 18 months ago. I love the look of that watch, the fade dial, the colours, that red looked fantastic. Mixture of Romans and Arabics, I think that is a little bit steampunky, especially when you slap a few octopi here and there. Now, I have reviewed a whole bunch of what I consider to be killer watches on the channel under $500 over the years, the best dive watch, the best field watch, and so on. One category where I haven't found the killer example though is the budget compressor case diver. But I think this new Phoebus Eagle Ray PY029 200 meter automatic dive watch, let's call it the Phoebus Eagle Ray compressor, could be the one that I have been looking for. And it looks fantastic. This one is 41 millimeters in diameter, 47 lug to lug, NH35 powered with a date at 3, but I can forgive it that because stylistically it looks amazing. Great selection of colors. There's a simple black, there's a green, there's a red. Oh, the red again. And there's a black and gold. I'm gonna have big difficulties deciding on which one to get in for review. And check out the bracelet, very much in the Omega Seamaster mold. It looks fantastic. Now the Omega Seamaster bracelet is one of the most comfortable bracelets on the market, full stop. So if they can replicate the comfort as well as the looks, Phoebus will be onto a winner with this one. Now these ones are launching next month, February 2021, for $360. However, don't forget, 10% off the PhoebusWatch.com website using the code JOMWA10, this or anything else you like. I'm very much looking forward to that one. You can find that link in the description of this video and every other video that I make as well. Next up at number three, it is the first non-dive watch. I did promise you three of them on the list, and it is the brand new Trasca Commuter, a slightly pedestrian name for a fantastic looking watch. I've got a lot of respect for what Trasca have done as a brand over the last few years and for the way that they've done it as well. They haven't just rushed designs to market willy-nilly. They seem to be moving at their own pace and really building something as a consequence. The Freediver was fantastic, as was the Summiteer. So they've got a dive watch and a field watch. This Commuter is their truly everyday watch. Did someone say Rolex Oyster Perpetual? I think perhaps that someone was me. Easy to see why though, especially when you look at the green one with those little colored marks around the indexes. And while I'm here, round of applause for the Trasca photographer. That is how you make a $550 watch look like a $5,500 watch. This one is actually launching tomorrow, the 10th of January. They're taking pre-orders at $50 off the normal price. This one is gonna be $565, but you can pre-order for $515, shipping in early March. It's a little smaller as well, 36.5mm in diameter, 44 lug to lug. So if you've got a smaller wrist or you just prefer a smaller watch, this one could fit the bill nicely. Slim at 10mm, but with 20mm lug width. Now they use their own proprietary scratch resistant coating on the case and the bracelet to ensure your Trasca will look as clean and as sharp as it does out of the box in a couple of years' time, and a fully articulating bracelet. Now, if that picture is accurate, then that really is a fully articulating bracelet. That should be super comfortable as well. Double domed, box domed sapphire crystal, solid end links, and they use a micro perlage finish on their clasps. The clasps have been really good on previous Trascas. 100 meters of water resistance, sunburst dial, and diamond cut hands. 500 bucks, they're creeping a bit north in price. They started off at 400 Trascas. I reckon it's gonna be worth it. I reckon they'll sell out very rapidly indeed. There are a few prototypes doing the rounds at the moment. I'm hoping to get one in before they sell out. At number four, it is the first of the two Aussie watches on the list today. It is the John Robert Archetype. Now, John Robert is the name of the owner of the company, but they're also the names of his two grandfathers, John and Robert, so it's not just a vanity exercise. He is based over in Melbourne, and we have been chatting for the last couple of months about getting one of these archetypes in for review. It is a linen dial watch. I have never used those two words in combination on the channel. When did you last hear of a relatively affordable linen dial watch? The only ones that I'm aware of have all been vintage, and vintage equals nightmare in my opinion. I would much rather buy a new watch that looked like an old watch than an old watch that would soon end up in the bin. How does he describe this one? All the style and elegance of a dress watch with the rugged durability of a tool watch. It's another one of these watches that is a little bit smaller at 38mm. I think that is going to be a trend that we see over the course of 2021. I think it's a trend that has been well established up till now. Watches becoming a little bit smaller and a little bit more wearable with a nice compact lug to lug. Now, John has not done things by halves for his first watch. Not only is this one Swiss made, he has gone straight to the top of the tree with a top grade Sellita SW200 movement. You can also get this in high accuracy quartz, powered by an ETA 64.111, accurate to plus or minus 10 seconds per year. So if it's going to be an occasional wear watch for you, maybe the quartz is a good one to have sitting in the corner of your box when you need it. Three colorways, white, blue, and charcoal. It will come with either a leather strap or I'm fancying the Jubilee. Jubilees are fantastically comfortable. So 30th of January 2021 is the Kickstarter launch date. High accuracy quartz will be going for $389, so we are a little more expensive with this one. $789 is the starting price for the top grade Sellita 200 model. The most expensive watch here today, I don't think it's going to sell in the hundreds of thousands as a consequence. I'm not sure whether that was what John was going for in the first place, but he certainly hasn't held back in terms of specs. That's a really expensive piece of sapphire crystal, X1 grade Superluminova as well, 100 meters of water resistance, 3-year battery life from one of those high accuracy quartz, and like I said, the whole thing is Swiss made. Certainly not a designy pick from a catalogue, that's for sure, and I wish him all the best with it. Now, the second Aussie watch is the second watch by Second Hour Watches, if you see what I mean. Launching in March 2021 on Kickstarter, it is the Mandala. Now, this is the follow-up to their Gin Clear Diver that launched at the beginning of last year. I didn't review the Gin Clear, but I'm keen to get my hands on a Mandala before that campaign begins, 17th, 18th March. I talked earlier on about innovation, about style, about quality, and about value being the real drivers behind the microbrand market over the course of this year. I think the Mandala possesses all of those qualities. Miyota 9039 high beat movement, 40mm diameter, 45mm lug to lug, again nicely wearable, 10.3mm thick including the sapphire crystal, but with 20mm lugs if you do want to swap the straps out. Flat sapphire with beveled edge, 6 layers of anti-reflective undercoating, custom made hands and custom made case, 100 meters of water resistance, screw down crown, 9 link custom made screw link bracelet, and check out that decorated custom movement rotor. Really the big selling point of this one though is going to be that multi-layered geometric pattern dial with cantilevered indices at the 12, 4 and 8 o'clock positions. Clearly that is going to be a bit of a thing for Second Hour, that is going to be their signature look. Prominent indexes at the 12, the 4 and the 8. I think it works very, very well with this Mandala design due to the inherent complexity of that Mandala cutout. Colour again is going to be a big thing I think in 2021. You're not short here, there's a pale blue, there's a salmon, there's a black with gilt, and Peter, the brand owner, is clearly a dinky die Aussie because he's made one in green and gold. The full RRP on this one is going to be $575, but the much more reasonable Super Early Bird Special on Kickstarter when it launches on the 17th or 18th of March is $425. Put a note in your calendar for that one. And last but by no means least, it is the watch on my wrist today. I did say I had a bit of an exclusive for you. I do not think that the company has even released images of this one on Instagram or their website. I'm delighted to be able to show you the prototype. It is the RZE Endeavor Titanium Dive Watch. Now this is another artist formerly known as. It's the artist formerly known as Risa Watches, or at least that's the name that they released the Resolute Titanium Field Watch on last year. Did very, very well on Kickstarter. I think they sold nearly 500 units, and well they might have because it was great. Super, super clean, super sharp piece of design, and they have continued that design philosophy through to this second example, the Endeavor Dive Watch. So full titanium dive watch with Seiko NH38, so you get the proper no date movement. They've got an in-house proprietary coating that they're calling Ultra Hex, meaning that this is now 8 times harder than stainless steel. Not only therefore is it 8 times harder than stainless steel, but it is also considerably lighter than stainless steel. Sized up for my 7-inch wrist, this one weighs in at bang on 99 grams. Now that, I'm sure, will be really, really appealing to a lot of watch guys and watch girls. 40.5mm in diameter, but wears like a much smaller watch because of that lack of weight. Super short 46 lug to lug again. 200 meters of water resistance, fantastic lume, sapphire crystal with super anti-reflective coating on the underside. This is very, very nicely made, including a screw-down solid titanium case back with Viton gasket. What price for all this titanium goodness, I hear you ask? Well, they'll be taking pre-orders for this one from their website. I'll leave a link to that in the description of the video also. From next month, February 2021, for $359. I think that is very fair indeed. So there you have it. That is my top 6 microbrand watches to look out for the first quarter of 2021. I think a fantastic selection. Certainly not the usual NH35 powered Submariner alike stainless steel dive watches, that's for sure. 3 divers, 3 non-divers. No shortage of colour, no shortage of design, no shortage of technological innovation there to be had as well. Great to see a couple of Aussie brands finally represented on the channel. Leave me a comment, let me know what you think of that lot. Let me know if I've missed any that have been on your radar as well. Thanks for watching. I will see you in those review videos, if not before.